Woodstock. Will it be or won't it be? And could the next James Bond be a female? And you won't believe what Bradley Cooper is saying about his co-star Lady Gaga. I think he wants to hook up with her.
It's three topics in 3 minutes. Hi there, I'm Nikki.
And I'm Joni, so let's get to it.
All right, so Woodstock 50, it's set for August 16th through the 18th. They made an announcement the other day, Joni, that it was canceled, but now they're saying it is not canceled. So who knows what the deal is, right?
Well, I know I've heard that the people financing it have already put like $30 million into it. The promoters say they still want to do it. And all these singers have already been paid.
So the main dude, the promoter of this thing, he says, you know what? We're going to get new financial partners, no problem. So you can bank on it. Because he said, quote, we are committed to ensuring that the 50th anniversary of Woodstock is marked with a festival deserving of its iconic name and place in American history and culture. Bottom line is, we're going to be a Woodstock 50th anniversary festival, as there must be, and it's going to be a blast.
I don't believe anything until the tickets are actually for sale.
They haven't even gone on sale. They were supposed to go on sale last weekend, I think, or maybe even 2 weekends ago. So we'll have to see.
Daniel Craig is set to play his last installment of James Bond, but the movie doesn't come out until 2020. However, he's now saying that maybe the next James Bond should be a female.
I don't know about that, Joni. I don't know.
My theory on that is, you know, his wife, Academy Award winner Rachel Weisz, who's also British, could probably definitely be, you know, in that James Bond vein. So maybe he's trying to score some points at home.
Well, that's possible, but I think she does okay on her own. I don't think she needs his help. But I think the only way that a James Bond would work with a female lead is if perhaps it was his daughter. But even then, that's a stretch. James Bond is, Ian Fleming is James Bond, right?
Yeah. Now, yeah, and I'm thinking, you know, as James Bond, a female, not so sure about that, but there have definitely been a lot stronger female leads in the James Bond. Think about Halle Berry, who played Jinx. I mean, she was one of the first really strong females. So we'll have to wait and see.
And Bradley Cooper was on Ellen the other day, and of course Ellen's like, oh my gosh, everybody, America loves you and Lady Gaga. You're the perfect couple, and they love your love story. I think you two should go on tour. Well, Bradley Cooper says, nah, I don't think I'm going on tour, but I think I have kind of a cool idea that I'd like to toss around.
Yeah, he's talking about a one-night-only live reading of A Star Is Born. And then, of course, you know, they would sing, but this would be very, like, intimate. He's saying something like for the Hollywood Bowl.
Yeah, live script reading into the songs and all that stuff. So basically, they're just doing a live reenactment of the film.
I want to see a live reenactment from that Oscar song when they sang at the Oscars.
And then at the end,
remember how the light was shining and they kind of leaned into
each other, cheek to cheek. Oh. And you know what? Bradley Cooper did admit he was really nervous about shooting that at the awards. However, he's the one that came up with a 360-degree concept. So he is a brilliant dude, Joni, not just hot.
He is brilliant. He says he's not a singer, but Bradley, you're pretty darn good.
I think that's our time, Joni.
Yeah, three topics in 3 minutes. See you next time. Bradley Cooper.